Chris Xand is a bit heartbroken.
Well, that nicely introduces today's topic,
the heart.
For this experiment, you will need 4 plastic bottles,
4 balloons,
4 straws, ideally flexible ones made of silicone, 1 pair of scissors, some sticky tape, some blackcurrant cordial, and that's everything.
Now, first of all, we need you to cut the top off the bottle.
Hang on a minute. Grown-up alert. Ask a handy adult to help you cut the bottles, and remember to be careful with the scissors.
And it's a beautiful job!
Next, cover the ragged edge of the bottle with a bit of tape. And do the same for each of the 4 bottles. These can be reused or recycled after the experiment.
So the next thing that we need to do is cut the balloons. Perfect, so now I have a sort of little swimming cap.
Then stretch this over the bottle and secure with a bit of tape.
The next thing to do is cut a very tiny little hole into the balloon.
Not too big, because when the straw is pushed through, there needs to be a tight seal.
So now we need to do the same on the other side of the balloon. So what we've made here is the left side of the heart. So I can put a little sign there.
Next, repeat this process with the other 3 containers to represent the body, the right-hand side of the heart, and the lungs.
We're going to connect the left heart to the body. The left heart is sending oxygenated blood out to the body. And oxygenated blood is bright red. And then the blood leaving the body to go back to the next part of the circulatory system is a bit more blue because it's lost its oxygen. So I'm going to use a blue silicone straw. Now the body drains the blood into the right heart.
So connect the two together.
Now the right side of the heart needs to send blood to the lungs. The deoxygenated blood goes back to the lungs to pick up oxygen again. And so by the time the blood leaves the lungs, it is bright red, represented by that red straw.
If you're smart, you'll start by adding the blood to the left heart chamber at the beginning.
At the beginning. Okay, so I'm gonna pour it in through here. And the important thing to know about how to make this model work is that the blood can only flow one way through the heart because of the valves. With this model, you have to act as the mitral valve by squeezing the tube between the left side of the heart and the lungs. So the blood has to go towards the body. And now we're ready for the first heartbeat. Are you ready, Chris? 3, 2, 1. And the blood is pouring around the system. That's amazing.
Keep pumping. Xand has now squeezed almost all the blood from the left heart into the body.
Now I act as if I'm a valve to stop blood flowing back to the left side of the heart, and I give the body a bit of a squeeze. This is absolutely excellent. And look at that, Chris. It's now in the right heart, and if I squeeze that tube again and squeeze, the right heart contracts, pushing the blood into the lungs. And now the blood is in the lungs.
As the blood drains from the lungs back into the left side of the heart, the cycle is complete.
It took me a couple of minutes to get the blood all the way around the different parts of the circulatory system. Amazingly, your heart can do that in just a couple of seconds. It really is extraordinary.